very quickly, Mr. Sharad Pradhan, before I go to that interview that I'm very keen to play so that Mr. Jaitley can hear himself how Azam Khan stands by. The comment you've just heard from the SP leader, spokesman in fact, is that it would be unfair to comment. Does that not suggest that they care more about Azam Khan and his feelings and his sensibilities than they care about the army and the terrible hurt done to the army?
It's very evident, you know, that for them their political compulsions are more important than anything else. And as we can see, it is not only Mr. Shivpal Yadav, Akhilesh Yadav himself, the Chief Minister, in a rally in Pilibhit today, he gave a similar wishy-washy explanation. And he said that it is not just one particular community, without mentioning Muslims.
Right.
Everybody has contributed to the army in Kargil and all that. So he gave a similar wishy-washy because they don't have the courage to take on Mr. Azam Khan, especially at this juncture.
All right. Now,
when the elections are around the corner and he's the Muslim face, for them, political gains, politics is more important than any national prestige or the prestige of the army.
You're absolutely right.
That's
Mr. Pradhan. And
part.
I'm going to cut now to the particular interview my colleague Rahul Kanwal did earlier today with Mr. Azam Khan. Rahul Kanwal asked Mr. Azam Khan how he defended his controversial statement. The interview has been trending all day on Twitter, where it's attracted enormous attention. Here now are edited excerpts so that you can see for yourself just how stubborn Mr. Azam Khan turns out to be.
आजम खान साहब, ये बताइए, आपने एक बयान दिया कल कि करगिल की लड़ाई में मुसलमानों का रोल था और करगिल की लड़ाई में कई जगहों पर नहीं नहीं बुरा नहीं लगा, मेरी बात तो सुनिए। आर्मी में मेरे पिताजी फौज में हैं, मैं खुद फौजी बैकग्राउंड से आता हूँ। फौज में सिखाया जाता है कि हिंदू मुसलमान सिख ईसाई कुछ नहीं होता, एक सर्वधर्म स्थल होता है, सब मिलकर वहां पर पूजा।
रेजिमेंट नाम की रेजिमेंट है, गोरखा रेजिमेंट है। मुसलमान अगर कुर्बानी दे तो आपको बुरा क्यों लगता है?
आप बात नहीं समझे।
आपने ये समझाया है पूरे देश को कि मुसलमानों का कोई योगदान नहीं है।
नहीं, किसने बोला ये?
आपने
नहीं।
हम बताते
नहीं, हमारे हिंदू तो आर्मी में क्यों?
हमारी बात तो सुन लीजिए। आपने सवाल किया, हमारा जवाब। आपने ये समझाने की कोशिश नहीं की देश को कि अशफाक उल्लाह खां की क्या कुर्बानी है, बीएमआ की क्या कुर्बानी है, मौलाना मोहम्मद को नहीं, आप नहीं करने देते,
सब सलाम करते,
नहीं करने देते आप। हमारी बात भी सुन लीजिए। कारगिल की पहाड़ियों पर मुसलमान फौजियों ने नारा तकबीर अल्लाह अकबर लगाकर पहाड़ियों पर चढ़ाई की, दूसरी तरफ के फौजी पाकिस्तानी बाहर निकल के आए, उनसे मुकाबला हुआ, इन्होंने मारा, पहाड़ियों को कब्जा किया।
मैं जानता हूं कहानी।
अगर मुसलमान फौजी अपने वतन की सरहदों की रखवाली के लिए जान दे रहे हैं और हम ये बता रहे हैं देश को, आपको क्यों बुरा लगता है?
सर, मेरे पिता नहीं,
ये तो हिंदू
नहीं, पर मेरी बात सुनिए।
नहीं,
मेरी बात सुनिए। आप उसको हिंदू मुसलमान क्यों करते? कोई ये थोड़ी कहता कि सिख जवान ने ये किया, मतलब भारत की सेना ने ये अचीव किया, उसको आप हिंदू मुस्लिम कलर क्यों देते हैं? आजम खान साहब,
नाम इतना बुरा क्यों?
हमें नहीं लगता, हमारे बहुत अच्छे पसंदीदा दोस्त, हमारे बहुत।
आपको ये बात क्यों बुरी लगती है? आप हिंदू हैं कि ये सच नहीं है?
आर्मी में
आप हिंदू हैं, ये सच नहीं है?
मैं तो सिख हूं, लेकिन
आप सिख हैं, ये सच नहीं है?
हिंदू,
मैं मुसलमान हूं, ये सच नहीं है?
पर आप हिंदू मुस्लिम का एंगल आर्मी को क्यों देते?
हिंदू मुस्लिम नहीं है,
आपने दिया।
अब आप कहते रहिए, आपके कहने से क्या होता?
नहीं, पर आपने कहा,
आपके कहने से क्या होता है? हमारा मंशा देश को ये साबित करना है कि मुसलमानों का क्या योगदान है और मुसलमान कहां तक जा सकता है। हमने ये कहा, वो तो आपने सुना और दिखाया, ये क्यों नहीं दिखाया कि देश की सरहदें हमें दो, कुर्बानी देने के लिए हम सब जान दे देंगे वतन के लिए, ये नहीं दिखाया आपने?
पर
हम सब जान दे देंगे,
जान देने के लिए सब बराबर से तैयार खड़े हैं।
अगर हम जान देना चाहते हैं आपसे पहले, तो आपको क्या एतराज है?
ये बताइए,
क्या एतराज है आपको?
नहीं, कोई एतराज नहीं।
तो फिर आप क्यों उसको ट्विस्ट करते?
क्योंकि
हैं,
आर्मी में हिंदू मुस्लिम नहीं होना चाहिए मेरे हिसाब से।
इसीलिए आर्मी चीफ गाजियाबाद से इलेक्शन लड़ रहे हैं भारतीय जनता पार्टी से, इसीलिए।
उन्होंने आपको जवाब दिया, उन्होंने कहा कि आर्मी में
उन्हें हक नहीं है जवाब देने का। अगर कोई मजबूत सरकार केंद्र में होती तो वो जवाब देती उन्हें।
आपको लगता है उनको निकाल देना चाहिए था?
अब पता नहीं क्या होना चाहिए था।
नहीं, पर मजबूत सरकार होती तो क्या संदेश देना चाह रहे हैं कि वीके सिंह को उस वक्त आप होते अगर डिफेंस मिनिस्टर इंडिया के और वीके सिंह ने इस तरीके से चैलेंज किया होता प्रधानमंत्री के?
General Malik, you might have noticed that in his answers, Azam Khan is trying a little to move away from his very odious Hindu-Muslim comparisons and trying to suggest instead that what harm is there if someone praises the good work done by Muslim soldiers. I'm not sure if it's a very convincing attempt, but how did you respond to what you heard Azam Khan say? Has he convinced you that what he said was anodyne as opposed to deeply offensive?
you know, I mean, it's a mad statement that he's making. The person has no clues whatsoever about the armed forces, how they work. He doesn't understand that we all work together as a team, from the smallest to the highest level of our organization. And we do not discriminate on the basis of religion, caste, or anything else. And that is the only way to fight a war, and that is the only way that we can survive as an armed forces. So that man has absolute no clues whatsoever. I do not know what is he doing as a minister in this UP state, Uttar Pradesh state. And I do not know how people have accepted him with this kind of a mindset, which can only destroy our secular institutions like the armed forces.
Can I ask you one quick question before I move on? The army is not just the most secular institution that India has, but probably one of the most highly regarded as well. In 2002 in Gujarat, it was the army that restored order. In 1984 in Delhi, it was the army that restored order. Is there a danger that Azam Khan's type of statements could create problems for the integrity of the army?
Yes, that is correct, because people like him, if they go about talking to people in their villages and their towns, it is bound to be heard by personnel in the army. And I don't like that. Let me also give you one anecdote. This is after the Kargil war, and one list of awardees came to me from 12 Jackalite. And I read that there was one Captain Clifford, a Christian. There was Captain Amol Kalia, who was a Hindu. There was one Ghaus Muhammad Khan from Kashmir, and there was one Sardar gentleman. Four, and my remark to my colleagues, my staff was, I said, this shows secularism in our country.
Absolutely.
Although it was not intended, but it just happened to be like that. And those four awardees are from 12 Jackalai, in which there are a large number of Muslims. I don't know what Azam Khan is talking about. He has no clue whatsoever, and I deeply condemn that statement of his.
Mr. Javdekar, listening to Mr. Azam Khan's original statement and now listening to the defense that he's put up, I got the impression that what he's ended up doing is to communalize valor, to communalize victory, and to communalize even martyrdom. Do you think that that is the great danger, that
Absolutely.
In every aspect he's introducing communal thought?
And he is making virtue out of it. And that is very bad of it. Nobody in the country has asked. And when there was a debate on whether there should be a census, on the religious census in the army, every sane person opposed it. But that is what now he is trying to again, and on the eve of election, just for votes, this is not Muslims also want now. Muslims have moved ahead. They want progress. They now don't want to be in that ghetto which SP and other parties, so-called secular parties,
I take your point. In other words, you're saying Azam Khan doesn't even understand the Muslim electorate he's trying to woo by this amazing controversial statement. Let me bring in Mr. Madhukar Jaitley, and I'm going to ask you two questions, Mr. Jaitley. First, I'm going to point out to you that in 2002, when Narendra Modi gave Hindu dead of Godhra double the compensation he gave the Muslims who were killed in Ahmedabad, MJ Akbar, who at the time was a leading editor, now he's the BJP spokesperson, had said that even in death, Mr. Modi was communalizing the Indian people. I put it to you, that is exactly what Mr. Azam Khan has also done. Even in death, he's communalizing the martyrs of Kargil. That is how deeply repugnant the statement happens to be. How do you defend
it? You see, it is not drawing the same comparisons. Kargil was not a communal riot, it was a war. And Gujarat was a communal tension was created because of Godhra, etc.
Mr. Jaitley,
so
I wasn't asking you to compare Kargil with Gujarat. I was asking you to compare the outcome of treating people differently on the basis of their religion. What you're happening and what you're seeing is Azam Khan claiming credit for the victory entirely for Muslim soldiers, and suggesting that Hindus had no role to play. And that's not only offensive, it's not only factually wrong. As you heard the former army chief say, it endangers the integrity of the army. Can't you be honest enough for once and say this was a terrible mistake? Put the army before the Samajwadi Party and say it. It was a terrible mistake. The country will applaud you if you say it. Go on. I'm giving you a chance. Say it now.
You see, we have already said that there is no caste in the army. All the Indians of the country stand together in the army and fight the forces against the nation, coming up against the nation to protect the integrity and honor of the country. Therefore, there is no need to say that any particular caste was already involved.
Mr. Jaitley, I'm asking a small, simple question. I'm going to repeat it one more time. I'm asking you to admit that Mr. Azam Khan made a terrible mistake. Admit it, and the country will applaud you.
Why do you want to jump to the conclusion, Karan, before the judgment of the election commission? The matter has been recognized. The cognizance of the statement has been taken by the election commission. They have issued a notice to Mr. Azam Khan. He is due to reply to that. Please wait for some time. Don't jump to the conclusion.
Okay.
We will abide by whatever decision is taken by the election commission.
Including the sharpest of admonition, will you also abide with an FIR if it is registered? Will you also accept arrest if it happens? All of those are possibilities. Will you accept all of that?
I will only say we will cross the bridge when it comes.
How convenient.
Again, you are trying to preempt the situation.